digestive system is the complex food particles should be grinded, should be converted into simple food particles which can be absorbed into the blood. So the overall process of the digestion consists of grinding of the food. So the food will be grinded in two ways. One is mechanical digestion. Mechanical digestion will happen in the mouth, so with the chewing part. And chemical digestion. Chemical digestion will be held with the help of enzymes. So in this picture, you are seeing the GIT. So we call from mouth to anus as GIT, gastrointestinal tract. And we have the salivary glands, liver, gallbladder, pancreas. These will comes under accessory digestive organs, which will helps for the digestion. So coming to the functions of the digestive system. So digestion is a process of converting complex food particles into simple absorbable food particles. So which is finally get absorbed into the blood and reaches to each and every cell of our body. And digestion will be happen in two ways. One is mechanical digestion and other one is chemical digestion. And finally, the absorption of the nutrients. Nutrients means carbohydrates, lipids, fats, vitamins and minerals. All these things we call it as nutrients. That is finally will get absorbed into the blood. And the unwanted and undigested will be eliminated from the body in the form of solid waste. We call that as fecal matter. So in this picture, you can able to see this is esophagus. And this is stomach. And from here, it starts the small intestine. So this entire thing. So this entire thing is the small intestine. And from here, it is the large intestine. So in the large intestine, you have this appendix, ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, sigmoid colon, rectum, and anus. So coming to the parts of the GIT. GIT is a continuous passage starting from the mouth till the anus. So oral cavity, which means mouth cavity. After oral cavity, we get pharynx. After pharynx, we get esophagus. After esophagus, we get stomach, small intestine, and finally colon or large intestine. So accessory digestive organs are pancreas, liver, gallbladder, and salivary glands. So coming to the combining forms, what we use under digestive system. Ano. Ano means anus. Appendo is appendix. Appendico is also appendix. Barrow. Barrow means weight. Bucco is cheeks. And coming to the next, ceco means cecum. Cecum is a part of large intestine. Col. Col means bile or gallbladder. And cholangio. Cholangio is bile duct. Cholecysto is gallbladder because cyst means bladder. And cholidoco. Cholidoco is common bile duct. I'll show you in the picture when it comes in detail anatomy. Colo is colon. And colono is also colon. Dento means tooth. Duodeno is duodenum. Entero is small intestine. Esophago means esophagus. Gastro is stomach. So gastrology, study of stomach. And gingive means gums. And glosso is tongue. Hepato is liver. Ileum. Jejuno is jejunum, which is a part of small intestine. Jejunum, duodenum, jejunum, ileum. These three are the parts of small intestine. Labio means lips. Lapro, it is abdomen. So for example, laparotomy, incision into the abdomen. Laparoscopy, instrument which is used to see for a visual examination of the internal organs of the abdomen. And lingo means tongue. Litho, stone. Odonto, which is tooth. Oro means mouth. Palato, which is palate. Pancreato, pancreas. And pharyngeo, throat or pharynx. Procto means rectum and anus. Together we call it as procto. And the study of rectum and anus, we call it as proctology. And recto means rectum. Sialadino is salivary glands. Sigmoido and sigmoid colon. And coming to the suffixes, emesis. Emesis means vomiting. Lithiasis. Lithiasis is formation of stones. Usually the stone will get formed in the gallbladder. orexia is appetite. For example, if it is anorexia, means loss of appetite. Pepsia is digestion. So the name Pepsi came from Pepsia only. Pepsia means digestion. And phasia. Phasia means eating or swallowing. Prandial. Prandial means meal. So mostly the diabetic, the sugar test and all, they'll give like PP. PP means postprandial, means after the meal. So the two sugar test was being done postprandial. If it is preprandial, means before meal. Trypsy means surgical crushing of the stones. So coming to the anatomy and physiology, the digestive system we also called as GIT, gastrointestinal tract, gut or elementary canal. So approximately 30 feet of continuous muscular tube starting from mouth to anus. And coming to the organs of the GIT, oral cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, and large intestine. So including the rectum and anus. So the parts of small intestine are duodenum, jejunum, ileum. So, and the accessory organs are salivary glands, pancreas, liver, gallbladder. So first, the three main functions of digestive system is, first, initially digesting the food. Next, absorbing the nutrients into the blood. Finally, unwanted and undigested food will get eliminated from the body in the form of fecal matter. So first, food digestion. So whatever we eat, it consists of carbohydrates, lipids and proteins. So carbohydrates will finally digested as glucose. Lipids are finally digested as triglycerides. And proteins as amino acids. So these things only will get absorbed into the blood. So the final products will get absorbed into the blood. And through cardiovascular system, it will be circulated throughout the body. So nutrients are essential for our body for growth and repair of the cells. And elimination of the waste. So some indigested food cannot be digested or absorbed. So it will be expelled from the body in the form of solid waste. We call that solid waste as fecal matter. And first organ is oral cavity. So initially, just see the parts here. So oral cavity will start with lips. So this is lips. For the lips, we have the medical terminology called labia or labo means lips. And this is teeth. Totally, we have 32 teeth. And for teeth, it is dento or odonto. And dentistry means study of teeth. And next, this is the palate. So in the anterior part, we have the hard palate. You can also check with your tongue. If you press in the front part of the tongue on the roof of your mouth, you can feel the hardness. That is actually the hard palate. If you go backside, then here. So here the palate is soft palate. And this hanging part, we call it as uvula. So this is uvula. So for example, if we touch uvula, we get vomiting sensation. So that we call it as gag reflex. And next we have the cheeks. For cheeks, it is buccal. Buccal means cheeks. And the lips are present anteriorly. The entire interior of the oral cavity was lined by mucous membrane. And the oral cavity also will digest the food mechanically by chewing. Tongue will help helps in movement of the food. And in the mouth, the food is mixes with saliva. So we call that food as bolus. And the taste buds will be present on the tongue. So the taste buds can detect bitter, sweet, salty and sour flavors. Coming to the teeth, we have four different sets of teeth. Incisors, canines, premolars and molars. And this was the real X-ray. So here you can see the wisdom teeth. So this is the wisdom teeth. And coming to the tooth structure. So whatever the thing, so this is the gums. So almost interior of the oral cavity was lined by mucous membrane. So this we call it a socket. Into which the tooth got embedded, we call this a socket. So above the gums, we call it as crown. So this part is crown. And below the gum is root. and the very outer region, outer covering of the tooth, so which is the shiny part of the tooth, we call it as enamel. And that was the hardest substance in our body. So tooth is technically, it is a bone only. So, but it comes under exoskeleton, means outside the body. So that's why we call it as, we don't call it as bone, but it was bone only. So this is the enamel part, this white color part is. And this bluish color part is the dentine. So dentine will form the bulk for the tooth. And this we call it as the pulp cavity. So when the pulp cavity goes down, this we call it as root canal. And here we have a material which makes the attachment of the tooth and the socket. This we call it as cementum or periodontal ligaments. And you can see here, this is the crown part and this is the root part. Enamel, dentine, pulp cavity. When it comes down, we call it as, here it is the root canal. And here you can see the periodontal ligaments. And this is the cementum. And these are the gums. And in the humans, we have two sets of teeth. We call that as deciduous teeth. So initially, when we are in the baby stage, so the teeth, we call it as baby teeth. Around 20 teeth, and out of 32, 20 teeth are the baby teeth. So that will come, that will erupt or fall down between the age of 6 to 28 months. And permanent teeth was the second set of teeth. So from 6 years, so our permanent set of teeth will be developed, so which will be replaced by the 32 permanent set of teeth. So the process will continue from 18 to 20 years of our age. And pharynx, so this is the pharynx. So the oral cavity will continue to the pharynx. Pharynx, we also call it as throat. And the pharynx is divided into three parts. So this we call it as nasopharynx, and this part is oropharynx, and this is laryngopharynx. In the nasopharynx, the nose is the entry. In the oropharynx, the mouth is the entry. And laryngopharynx, the larynx is the entry. So based on the entry, the part will be differ. And this part we call it as epiglottis. This epiglottis will be usually closed when we are eating and drinking. This will be open when we are speaking or breathing. At that time, this epiglottis will open. So this usually will prevent the food to fall into this respiratory tract. So in this picture, again, you can see this is the nasal cavity and this is the hard palate. This is the soft palate. And this we call it as uvula. So this hanging part. And this is the tongue. So this is the tongue muscle. And lips, teeth, and here we have the gums. And this, these are the palatine tonsils. So the tonsils present near the palate. And this we call it as lingular tonsils. The tonsils present nearby the tongue. And this is epiglottis. And these we call it as vocal cords. And this is esophagus. And this is trachea. So esophagus, which is 10 inches long muscular tube. When the food enters into the pharynx, from pharynx into the esophagus, the only work with the esophagus is, it was a connection between the oral cavity and the stomach. So it transports the food from the mouth to the stomach. So the movement which happens in the esophagus, we call it as peristalsis. So that usually will take the food from mouth to stomach. And next, stomach. Stomach was actually a J-shaped structure. So it usually has foldings. We call these foldings as rugae. So because of these foldings only, the stomach can able to stretch. So inside the stomach, we have the gastric juice. So the main element for the gastric juice is HCl, hydrochloric acid, which is highly acidic. So the pH is 1.8. So when the food mixes with the gastric juice, we call it as chyme. When the food in the mouth mixed with saliva, we call it as bolus. When the same food present in the stomach, we call it as chyme. So we have three parts with the stomach. This part we call it as fundus. And this is the body. And this lower part is the antrum. And coming to the sphincters. So sphincters are nothing but the muscular foldings. So which will usually control the flow of the food. So here we have two sphincters. One is a lower esophageal sphincter and other one is pyloric sphincter. So why do we have a sphincters? So it prevents the food to go backwards. We call that as regurgitation. So the regurgitation was prevented by the sphincters. So the, here the sphincter, we call it as lower esophageal sphincter. And this sphincter, we call it as pyloric sphincter. And small intestine. So which is the longest portion of the entire digestive tract is small intestine. It is around 20 feet long. It starts from the pyloric sphincter and ends till the colon. So the entire digestion will finally get completed in the small intestine. And majority of the food also will get absorbed in the small intestine. So it has three parts, duodenum, jejunum, ileum. Duodenum was 10 to 12 inches and it starts from the pyloric sphincter. Jejunum was the second longest part and it was about 8 feet long. And ileum was the third section. It is 12 feet long and ileum and colon was connected as ileocecal wall. It has a valve again. And colon. Colon was which is around 5 feet long. It extends from the ileocecal wall finally to the anus. So the fluid remained after the digestion will get absorbed in the colon. Most of the water also will get reabsorbed back into the body by the colon only. And the finally leftover solid waste, we call it as fecal matter. And it was evacuated with bowel movements. Coming to the regions of colon. So this we call it as ileocecal wall. Here we have the ileocecal wall. Once, even if anything was happened here, we can get the food out of the body through vomiting. If once the food crosses this ileocecal wall into this colon, it will never come back. So that's why here we have the wall. Here we have the sphincters. And this is the pyloric sphincter. And this part is the duodenum. And this part we call it as cecum. So cecum, appendix, and this is ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, sigmoid colon, rectum and anus. And rectum is the area where the fecal matter will be stored. So in this rectum only the fecal matter will be stored. So which finally leads to anus. So the rectum and anus together we call it as procto. And the study of rectum and anus we call it as proctology. For example, if the person is having hemorrhoids, we also call it as piles. So then he has to consult to the person called proctologist. So and the fecal matter will come out of the body through a process called defecation. So again, in this picture, you can see stomach, duodenum, and this is the ileocecal wall, cecum, appendix, ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, sigmoid colon, rectum, and anus. Coming to the accessory organs, these are the organs which helps for the digestion. So salivary glands, liver, gallbladder, and pancreas. As accessory organs plus GIT, together we call it as digestive system. Okay. And first is salivary glands. Salivary glands will produce saliva. So that usually will mix the food in the mouth. We call saliva plus food as bolus. It contains an enzyme called amylase. So that helps for the digestion of the carbohydrates. And we have three pairs of salivary glands. One is parotid. So this is the largest pair of salivary glands, parotid, which is present in the front of the ear part, parotid. And this is sublingual glands. And this is submandibular. Parotid, sublingual, and submandibular. So these are the three pairs of salivary glands present in our body. And liver. Liver was present on the right upper quadrant of the abdomen. Towards right side, we have the liver. And liver, we also call it as factory of our body. Because it mainly purifies the harmful substances and toxic substances in the food. And it produces the bile. So bile is very essential for the digestion of fat. We call that as emulsification. Emulsification means breaking the larger fat droplets into smaller fat droplets. That process will be done by this bile. And this was the liver. You can see this. And this is the gallbladder. So initially, from the liver, we have a tube. We call that tube as hepatic duct. And we have a tube from this gallbladder. We call that as cystic duct. So the combining of the cystic duct and hepatic duct, together we call it as common bile duct. And this common bile duct will combine with pancreatic duct to form hepatopancreatic duct, which finally opens into the duodenum. And gallbladder. Gallbladder is the region where the bile will store. So whenever the bile is needed, that will come out through this bile duct and that will go into this duodenum. And pancreas. Pancreas was been in the C-section, in the C column of the duodenum. So it also consists of digestive enzymes. So that will usually digest the carbohydrates, lipids and fats. So this is not acidic. So this will actually neutralizes the acidic chyme coming from the stomach. Again, you can see here the liver, hepatic duct and cystic duct. Together will combine to form common hepatic duct. Common bile duct. And the common bile duct and the pancreatic duct combine to form hepatopancreatic duct, which opens into the duodenum. So coming to the word building part, anal, pertaining or related to anus. Buccal, pertaining or related to cheeks. Labiobuccal, pertaining to the lips and cheeks. Because labio is lips, buccal means cheeks. Appendectomy, surgical removal of appendix. Appendicitis, inflammation of the appendix. If the person is having appendicitis, immediately they will go for appendectomy, surgical removal of appendix. So this is the part, this is appendix. So if any food get entered here and trapped here itself, it leads to inflammation of the appendix. So that we call it as appendicitis. And if the appendicitis happens, so the removal of the appendix will be happen, that we call it as appendectomy. And cholecystectomy, surgical removal of gallbladder. Cholecystogram, gram means taking an x-ray. Taking an x-ray of gallbladder. Usually stones will be formed very commonly in the gallbladder. Cholecystic, related to gallbladder. Cholecystalgia, algia means pain. So pain in gallbladder. Dental, pertaining to the teeth. Dentalgia, tooth pain. And this is the region. So this is gallbladder. So the inflammation of the gallbladder, we call it as cholecystitis. So then they will remove the gallbladder. That procedure we call it as cholecystectomy. And this was the laparoscope. So through this instrument, so the visual examination of the interior of the abdomen will be possible. Because lapro means abdomen. Scope means visual examination. So scope is the instrument help for visual examination. So mostly with laparoscopic instruments, the surgeries also will be done. So through the monitor, they will see what is inside and they will surgically remove the smaller parts. With the laparoscopy itself, they can remove the gallbladder. And colectomy, surgical removal of colon. Colostomy, creating a new opening in the colon. Colorectal, pertaining to the colon and rectum. Colonoscope, instrument which is used for visual examination of colon. Colonic, pertaining to colon. So this is colonoscope. Colonoscope instrument is usually inserted from the anal region. So to see inside the colon. And the tonsils you can see here. If the tonsils present near the pharynx, we call it as pharyngeal tonsils. If the pharynx near the palatine, then it is palatine tonsils. If it is on the tongue, it is lingual tonsils. Duodenal, pertaining to duodenum. Enteric, pertaining to the intestine. Enteritis, inflammation of the intestine. Esophageal, pertaining to esophagus. Esophagectasis, dilation of the esophagus. Gastralgia, stomach pain. Gastric, pertaining to stomach. Gastroenteritis, inflammation of the stomach. Gastroenterologist, stomach specialist. Gastromalacia, stomach softening. Nasogastric, pertaining to the nose and stomach. Gastrostomy, creating a new opening in the stomach. Gastroscope, instrument to view inside the stomach. Gastritis, inflammation of the stomach. and gastrectomy, surgical removal of the stomach. And this is the gastrectomy. So this is usually done for obesity people. They will remove a portion of the stomach. So they can decrease the capacity of the stomach. So the food consumed by the person will be very less because the capacity of the stomach got decreased. And gingival, pertaining to the gums. Gingivitis, gum inflammation. Glossal, pertaining to the tongue. Hypoglossal, under the tongue or below the tongue. So this is gingivitis, the inflammation of the gums. Hepatitis, inflammation of the liver. Hepatoma, liver tumor. Hepatic, pertaining or related to the liver. Ileal, pertaining to ileum. Ileostomy, new opening into the ileum. So this is the normal healthy liver and this is hepatitis. Hepatitis is usually caused by the virus also. Hepatitis A, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, hepatitis D virus. Jejunal, pertaining to the jejunum. Laparotomy, incision into the abdomen. Laparoscopy, instrument for visual examination of inside the abdomen. Sublingual, under the tongue. Hypoglossal or sublingual, both are same. Orthodontic, maintaining the straight tooth. Oral, pertaining to mouth. Palatoplasty, surgical repair of the palate. Pancreatitis, inflammation of the pancreas. Pancreatic, pertaining to pancreas. Pharyngeal, pertaining to pharynx. Pharyngoplegia, pharynx paralysis. And pharyngoplasty, surgical repair of the pharynx. And proctoptosis, drooping or falling of rectum and anus. And proctologist, rectum and anus specialist. Proctopexy, surgical fixation of rectum and anus. Pyloric, pertaining to pylorus. Rectal, pertaining to the rectum. And sialadenitis, inflammation of the salivary glands. And sigmoidoscope, instrument to view inside sigmoid colon. And sigmoidal, pertaining to sigmoid colon. So this is sigmoidoscope instrument, which is used to view inside the sigmoid colon. Hematemesis, blood vomiting, because hemato means blood, emesis means vomiting. Hyperemesis, excessive vomiting. Anorexia, lack of appetite. And dysorexia, abnormal appetite. Postprandial, which means after the meal. And bradypepsia, slow digestion. Dyspepsia is abnormal digestion, abnormal or painful digestion. Aphasia, lack of eating. And dysphasia, abnormal eating. Polyphasia, which is too much eating. So, yeah, that's it. Any doubts regarding this topic? In this topic, you have to know entire thing about the anatomy and physiology, each and every part, coming from the oral cavity till the anus, and about the accessory digestive organs. And till now, it was the word building part, how to construct the word, words in digestive system. So far this, till here, if you're having any doubts, let me know.